The Surrey Fire and Rescue Service Ray Park Training Centre is located in Reigerton, Surrey, on the edge of the North Downs. The fire service has used this site since 1947, and it's now well established as an international training centre of excellence. The current facilities were refurbished in 1987 and now offer modern training facilities for not only recruit firefighting training, which this film shows, but also industrial fire safety training. The accommodation blocks are modern and comfortably furnished, giving the students their first full insight into the world of modern-day firefighting techniques. The site is well laid out, so the transition from classroom theory to fireground practical training is speedily carried out. We're going to follow a group of recruits through some of their initial training modules, culminating with their passing out parade. To be able to wear with pride the British Fire Service cap badge, every recruit must undergo 14 weeks of basic training, involving many hours in the classroom learning the theory of firefighting. The subjects covered include hydraulics, electricity, building construction, chemistry, and fire service legislation. Experienced junior officers make up the instructional staff, all having their own specialist fields. The recruits are assessed regularly during their course and must meet the required standard throughout. The centre is equipped with many visual aids. This one is a fire pump which has been sectioned to allow the inner workings to be seen and for the theory to be understood. The fire service is a disciplined organisation, and the recruits soon learn the intricacies of foot drill. Moving around in an organised manner as a group is an essential part of the team-building attitude, which is so vital in the service. Within a few short weeks, they look as professional at marching as the armed services. Every Friday morning, the senior instructor closely inspects the squads.
Got no shows playing, Mr. Carr? Sir.
Standards are high and are expected to be maintained throughout the course.
Need of a haircut there, Mr. Wimborne?
Yes, sir!
Got fluff all over your trousers, Mr. Wimborne, and all over your cap.
Yes, sir!
This is all part of the ongoing assessment process, which will turn a civilian off the street into a professional firefighter. The classroom theory is now put to practice. Here, a recruit is practicing one method of getting from a ladder into a window opening. There is also a correct way of getting off a ladder as well.
Three, two, one, step off!
These harnesses are used for practicing carrying a person down from an upper floor. Crews are paired up, and then it's over your shoulder with the body and onto the ladder, three floors up. This is perhaps the most spectacular method of rescue, and demands a great degree of skill and strength, balancing the body whilst ascending the ladder.
Three, two, one, step off!
Every recruit will carry and in turn be carried. No one can help you here. You're on your own. It's all down to you. The harness is attached to a safety line. If a body is dropped, the line is attached to a brake which will actuate immediately, leaving the body suspended from the safety line rather than making a potentially fatal trip to the ground. Once off the ladder, the body has to be laid on the ground properly so that first aid can commence immediately, which may well save a person's life. The recruits soon learn how to handle the fire service ladders proficiently. The instructors strictly monitor all drills, correcting any errors along the way. They're heavy, and if not handled correctly, accidents can happen, which of course must be avoided. The course includes some off-site training. Here we see the recruits undergoing a water relay exercise. This simulates a remote fire situation some distance from their appliances and a mains water supply. The portable pumps, hose and other equipment have to be carried to the fire ground. In this case, a riverside location accessed only by going down a steep embankment.
okay? Let's look. Okay, just play it out.
The base pump is soon lured down to the riverside along with its equipment. Meanwhile, the other crew members have taken the other pump to its intermediate point along the route and are now joining up the pumps with hose. The recruits will eventually serve in county fire brigades and will frequently become engaged in fighting heathland, forest and field fires. Carrying hose over a long distance is very arduous and requires a great deal of stamina. Over 50 lengths of hose are used in this exercise. Once carried to the approximate locations, the hose is run out and coupled together. With water now being supplied from the base pump, the intermediate one is started to add its pressure to the supply. As usual, the instructors are close at hand, evaluating the students' actions. After many lengths of hose have been laid and water supplied to the fire scene, the instructors go to check on the crews. Meanwhile, the refreshments are brought on for everyone to have a well-earned cuppa. With the daylight fading, everything now has to be made up and returned to the vehicles over half a mile away. Fire is the enemy of the firefighter. So the more the recruits learn how to deal with it, the better. They undergo a series of hot fire training in the firehouse facility. Here they are being briefed by the instructional staff on how they're going to tackle it. The training fire has been cooking up for some time, so into action they go. Students have already trained with breathing apparatus, and the purpose of this exercise is to enter and rescue some trapped people. spec draft procedures are followed, and the first crews make an entry. It is very hot and smoky. Water supplies are arranged, and the next team to go in is prepared. A second crew enters. A third team stands by the entry control as backup. The first team reappears, the low air pressure whistles sounding. The team leader briefs the entry control officer of his findings.
Right, okay, right hand search, yep. In there, you get into the stairs. Okay, keep going round, find a door, you go and right in place. So we've got about like a few metres round, yeah, and that's where we stop searching. Quite sure we know exactly what we're doing.
Gone up.
Okay, when you get to the top of the stairs, yeah, that needs searching. You've done part, say, about 4 or 5 metres in, bow down.
The third team is deployed. The first of the casualties is rescued.
Phil,
I need a hand.
And the second crew is debriefed.
Followed the voice.
Went to the left hand search. Have you seen any rooms on the way?
No, it's all just one room.
Air cylinders are changed and the crew re-enters for a second time. The third team takes a breather. The instructors discuss the exercise progress. And the last casualties are removed. The crew now enters by another access point and finally extinguishes all the fire. We are now at the end of the recruits' 14 weeks training. They've sat their exams, and most have passed. This is pass-out day, and the recruits' families and friends have gathered to watch their display, along with the VIPs and guests.
Station, sir.
The parade is inspected by the senior officers from Surrey Fire and Rescue Service, along with senior officers from the other county fire brigades whose recruits have been trained at Ray Park. The recruits stage a series of practical demonstrations for their guests. The first is a foam drill. Two cars have collided and are on fire. The equipment is made up and returned to the appliances. A road traffic accident now takes place. Thank you. recruits show how a casualty is removed from a crashed car. The roof is removed using the jaws of life and an air-operated saw.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, as can be seen, all gear is made up as quickly as possible, thus ensuring that these appliances will be available should another emergency arise.
A fire situation now develops in the Ray Park apartments. Two rescues are made, one using the 135 metre ladder and the other with the 9 metre ladder. Covering jets are got to work and water supply is laid out. A carry-down rescue is made using the 135 metre ladder.
The person being carried down the ladder at the moment is an instructor at the Ray Park Centre.
And a walk-down rescue via the 9 metre ladder as well.
Left!
And so, one of the first items of equipment to be returned to the advised is...
Set still on the hydrant. Don't make up the hydrant.
The fires are soon extinguished and all equipment is returned to the appliances.
Ladder secure!
The appliances are soon ready for redeployment into the last demonstration. This one demonstrates how much water can be speedily deployed from three fire appliances.
Carry on, sir. Thank you, sir. Carry on, Mr. Cook. Right on the right tile. Right, sir. I left. Come on, back.
This will request, ladies and gentlemen, this will return the plastic element of the display.
During the interlude, a fire safety demonstration is given. Fireman Sam hands out sweets, whilst volunteers are used to put out a flat pan fire. It concludes with a demonstration of what can happen when water is applied to a fat pan which is on fire.
Shredded hair, that behaves as
The recruits then re-emerge for the presentation ceremony, where they're awarded with their certificate of training by the County Deputy Chief Fire Officer. The premier award of the Silver Axe goes to the best recruit on the course.
And I'm pleased to say that the senior award, of course 397, goes to firefighter Wimborne to the Surrey Fire and Rescue Service. The future of the service is in your hands. The older people like me will be retiring soon.
I'm sure you have already heard about all the reviews, all the things that are going on in the service. And I feel confident, having seen that display this afternoon, that we can hand over the service safely into your hands for the future. Let me finish by saying well done, and I'm sure all of us here would wish you a successful and enjoyable career in the fire service. Thank you.
And so, congratulations go to the recruits as they complete their initial training course in firemanship at the Ray Park Centre.